Hello, everyone, and welcome to Mr. This is Southeast Asia, and this is the island of Timor, and here is East Timor. Now, let's see more of Timor, shall we? Since the name Timor derives from the Malay word for east, East Timor literally means east, east. The first persons who inhabited this island came from the north, however, Austronesians from South Asia. They lived in caves and fished for tuna and made seashell necklaces, but little else can be known from those long ago days. Sometime around 3000 BC, the Melanesians arrived, and then the Malay peoples from southern East Asia followed. Chiefdoms were established, because wherever people are, someone has to be the boss over them for some reason. And Timor became a stopping point for various Asian merchants and traders, who had a particular fondness for the island's ample stores of sandalwood, a commodity much desired for its durable fragrance. This is what attracted European explorers and colonizers. The 1500s saw Portugal settle in and slowly take control, introducing corn, coffee, and Catholicism. The mid-1600s saw the Dutch sweep into the Indonesian archipelago and incrementally conquer it. And while they fought Portugal for Timor, they never managed to get it completely. The island was split in two, with Portugal running the east and the Dutch the west, which was formally ratified in 1859. For centuries, Portugal had not invested very heavily in the island, but as its own economy flagged, it pushed for further Timorese resource extrication, but not for better work conditions for laborers, which sparked a big rebellion that forced Portugal to bring in soldiers from Mozambique and this gunboat to suppress it. But as unideal as Portuguese rule was, 1942 saw the beginning of an all-too-real nightmare as the Japanese invaded and planted their imperial flag on Timorese turf as part of their conquest of the Pacific. Australia feared they would be next and sent soldiers north to hinder Japanese territorial ambitions. The Dutch also sent some forces, and the Timorese were only too happy to help, as the Japanese were taking all the food and burning villages. Gritty, grisly guerrilla warfare ensued, hampering Japanese expansion, but leaving over 40,000 Timorese dead. In 1945, Japan surrendered and withdrew, and the Portuguese were welcomed back. But the age of colonies was winding down. In 1974, Portugal's new government favored decolonization, and East Timor's left-wing political party, Fretilin, declared independence on the 28th of November 1975. A few days later, Indonesia invaded and took control, ostensibly to quash the threat of communism. The world condemned Indonesia's occupation of East Timor, and the East Timorese spent over 20 years fighting Indonesian forces, encouraged and inspired by the courageous Catholic bishop Father Bello. International pressure finally forced Indonesia to withdraw in 1999, having been responsible, through killings, famine and so on, for up to 200,000 East Timorese deaths. 2001 saw East Timor vote in democratic elections, and Mr. Gusmao here became first president. Since then, East Timor has recovered as best it can, but there is a long way to go, and about half the populace lives in poverty. If the country ever gets round to building a railway, it is believed the economy will begin to surge. Let's hope so, as this country has suffered enough. So best of luck to East Timor. Until next time, bye-bye!